Welcome to the Renaissance and welcome to the alleged killing of twins and Mary Slessor hoax, part 1. And this very important notice to you, our dear viewer, this video is not intended to offend anyone. It is not a propaganda video. It is made in good faith for educational and reference purposes only. Please look for the materials referenced and study them yourself. Remember, I do not think that the suffering that is going on in Biafra can be met by the stopping of British arms supplies to Nigeria. The Commonwealth Secretary, George Thompson, to the Commons, circa 1967, and from the book, The Brutality of Nations, by Dan Jacobs. And from Benjamin Adekunle of the Nigerian Army, which was a slave hunting militia, I want to see no Red Cross, no Caritas, no World Council of Churches, no Pope, no missionary, and no UN delegation. I want to prevent even one Igbo having one piece to eat before their capitulation. We shoot at everything that moves. Then we shoot at everything, even things that don't move. And this was from the Amsterdam newspaper, The Telegraph. And this is also from the book, The Brutality of Nations. Lessons from the United States elections. Do you remember when we read about how the Fulani emirs were against stopping the slave trade because their economy depended on the slave trade? Do you also remember the recent NSAS protests, which we think is more of a slave insurrection in Nigeria, and how the Fulani governors of the north supported SAS and were against the protests? Do you also remember northern governors, that is almost all of them are Fulanese? Remember, the Fulanese are incited or made to believe they are superior by the slave masters. So they always try to be leaders, even in things and areas they have little or no understanding of what it's all about. And they try to impose themselves on others and try to conquer everyone else, especially the Negroes, and take over their lands, the same way they did to Hausa people and what is northern Nigeria today. Remember, they did the same thing to the Hausas and took over their land. And just so you know, all the emirs you see in the north are Fulanese, the governors Fulanese, the Nigerian president the Fulani, the Sultan Fulani, most of their imams Fulanese, every leadership position they occupy. So when they take over your land, they first come in gradually as if they are harmless. The slave master knows what we are telling you now. That's why the British has a policy of ruling through the Fulanese. So when they come in, they start settling, gathering. While you're thinking you just have some people that came in, you won't know that one day they will rise up, kill all the kings and take over the place. That's how they conquer, and they boast about it. They say they can conquer the whole world if the salt water does not stop them. And they brag that they are going to dip their Quran, which is the Arab Quran anyway, into the ocean, which is what you see happening there today. Do you also remember that the British sponsored SARS? Remember the anti-SARS protests, and the British were sponsoring the SARS the same way they sponsored the slave hunters? That's the same thing they are doing. The voice of Jacob and the body of Esau, that's their trick. It doesn't change. Do you also remember that after COVID-19 left China, the British Prime Minister, Prince Charles, British Health Minister, El-Rufai, Atiku's son, etc., all claimed to have tested positive to the virus, even when in Nigeria there were no real test centers, they had no equipment or anything for such tests, but they claimed they tested positive. They even claimed they killed Abba Kyari. Remember, if the same man had died, let's say, before the lockdown, nobody would have said that's what killed him. You need to understand who these people are. They work together, but the slave master is a subtle beast. But his foot soldiers, they lack humanity, they lack common sense. They can massacre an entire community and ask you for more. They don't have any form of human feeling. Believe it or not, you can doubt us as much as you like, but if you research it, you will understand what we're saying. It should also explain to you why they were able to carry out the slave raids, capture men, women and children, murder those who refused to work or who got tired. That should tell you. If you also look at the Nigerian army today and how they are conditioned, with that absence of humanity and common sense, it will tell you all you need to know. Do you also notice that the Fulani in Nigeria hastily congratulated Biden, same way the British Prime Minister did? Buhari sent him congratulatory messages as well, the same way the British PM did, because these people worked together. They were slave hunting partners. They worked together. Follow their steps. You will understand what we're saying. You don't need to believe us. You don't even need to read too much books. You just need to follow their slave hunting partners. You will see their game very easily. And so, permit us to ask you very simple questions like, when you follow the Church of England, do you not ask yourself why it is not Church of Britain that you are following? Remember, we talk about the British as the colonial masters. But then in the church, they are telling you Church of England. You have Anglican, that's English. These were the brutal slave merchants and slave hunters at that time. So again, we ask you, why is it Church of England and not Church of Britain? Have you also wondered why most of the missionaries and explorers in the Bights of Biafra and Benin were from Church of Scotland instead of Church of England? And you can very easily name the likes of Hope Waddell, Mary Slessor, William Balfour Beatty, and Mungo Park. All came from either the Church of Scotland or they are Scottish. And even the Lander brothers, supposedly English, were also sent by the Church of Scotland. But today, you have your so-called Church of England. Have you ever sat back to ask yourself why? But during the slave trade, the Negroes were said to be eating their children, and the slave trade was to save those children. Remember, the slave master does not attack you without first accusing you of something. And you can see the same thing in a place like Nigeria today, in Biafra and in Ambazonia. If you remember the Biafran War of 1967-70, the slave master does not miss telling you that the Biafrans were rebels. But the question is, rebel against who? Who made them rulers and judges over us? That should be your question to ask, so that you understand where they are coming from and what they are saying when they are telling you one Nigeria. It is all about the slave trade. You don't need to believe us. We will prove it to you. And they also said that the Negroes were pagans and offered human sacrifices. Those being captured would have been sacrificed anyway. Those are some of the excuses and pretexts under which they were conducting their slave raids and slave hunts. And that the Negroes were naked, they lived on trees, and they were being kidnapped and enslaved to civilize them. Remember, they claimed that the Negroes were not human. So when they are telling you today about monkey chats and anti-racism or Black Lives Matter, it's all hypocrisy. Why not ask yourself why the likes of CNN, that tells you that Donald Trump is a racist, but does not report when people are massacred in Biafra or Ambazonia by their slave hunting partners? Ask yourself that simple question. Why would they tell you one and not tell you the other? If they loved you so much, would they be telling you about Trump and not tell you about your people being killed by their slave hunting partners? The reason they don't tell you all those is because you don't know that you are being enslaved, you are being massacred, your population is being controlled, your people are being killed. Because you don't care, you keep listening to what Massa is saying. You don't know that there are enemies within, right there where you stay. When you see the likes of Nweke in River State massacring innocent people, do you ask yourself who is doing the killing? Where did they plan it? Don't listen to what he's saying. He is just a house slave. He is saying what master asked him to say. The moment they go to Sokoto, they either enter into an oath or something happens to them, they lose their ability to reason like humans. You probably heard him in the interview with Mamodu saying that if you killed his children, no problem. If you killed his wife or his mother, no problem. You might think he just said those things and they have no meanings. That's what master asked him to say. He is a house slave, forget it. He didn't go to do the killings himself. The killings were done by the slave hunting army called Nigerian Army, the same way it would have been done during the slave trade. Now, they will go and write that when you kill the Negroes or kill their children, they don't care. Remember, that's what Wike is saying. That's what master had asked him to say. The Fulani control all of them. That's why if you watched that interview, the moment Mamodu asked him, what about the federal government negotiating with Boko Haram? He got angry, got visibly agitated, because that was not part of the script they gave him. He has to say what master asked him to say. He is just a house slave. There are no two ways about it. Forget whatever you're thinking. Ask yourself as an adult, why would an adult be killing his siblings in defense of a foreigner when that foreigner is not killing his own siblings? If you notice, the same way you see the Fulanese killing Nigerians in Nigeria in defense of the rubbish of one Nigeria, or in Cameroon in defense of one Cameroon for the French. Of course, Ambazonia is in British Cameroon while Biafra is in British Nigeria, so it's still the same British. And so you see that while the Fulanese are killing the people supposedly in the same country with them, but the British government does not kill the Scottish when they ask for freedom. But the Fulanese will not see that. They will not learn that, because their ability to reason is also blinded by what the slave master wants them to do. It is the same way that level of reasoning is cascaded to the governors you see in the south of Nigeria today, in the southern part of Cameroon as well. You will notice that they can never come together as one group. They can't even say it, because if they said it, they know that their master will remove them. That's why you notice that the northern governors can meet and announce what they want to be done in the whole Nigeria, and none of them will say anything. Even if they said anything, that's what the master asked them to say, so that people will not understand that they are just slaves. And going further, we also saw that they claimed the Negroes do not know God, and that the slave trade was to bring them to salvation. Remember that as well. And then permit us to ask you, are all these things you just read here any different from a brave snake saves a fish from drowning? And before we go into the alleged killing of twins proper, let us remember from the US elections that that's the same thing they do in sub-Saharan Africa and in the sub-region that causes the wars you see. And when they cause those wars, you will see something like African leaders never want to leave power. Remember, it is the cheating that is causing all the problem. You don't wake up and set rules. You don't obey those rules, but you want others to obey them. Remember, those are part of what makes the Negro slaves. If you think in places like Nigeria, the votes count. If you looked at the last election under Buhari and compare the fact that in 2015, the US president issued a statement on that election telling you the need to keep Nigeria one as a task that must be done. But in the second one that whoever they had there rigged himself back in, did you hear them make any statement? Did you hear them say anything? Now you're gonna say it's because it is Trump. Yes, Trump doesn't have that time. But remember to ask yourself, what has keeping Nigeria one got to do with an election when Obama was telling you that in 2015? That should tell you what they do. But without going further with that, let us try to understand the terrain we are looking at by referencing In the Niger Country by Harold Bindloss, and it was published 1898. And here we see a map. Please remember that if you asked an average Nigerian professor of anything, they will tell you Nigeria was either created or amalgamated in 1914. But please do not blame them. That's a lie we were all fed with. Remember, the slave master works with misinforming the children, and the educational system is a system that allows you to remember, not to think. It allows you and teaches you to remember, but not to think. So ideally, you are to be taught what the slave master wants you to know, and then you reproduce that as accurate as possible in an exam, so the slave master will pass you for the next grade. That's all it's all about. The educational system is for the Negroes to be taught to remember, but not to think. That's ideally what it's all about. It's mere conditioning. And so, looking at this map from a book of 1898, and please remember that the same slave master told us that Flora Shaw coined the name Nigeria from River Niger in 1914, following the amalgamation of the North and South. We have all seen today that that's a lie. Then the slave master, being a subtle beast, if you looked at the US election today, you will understand who they are. Even in their rigging, even in their fraud. Remember, it is the same cabal that removed Jonathan in Nigeria that are trying to remove Trump. We shall in a subsequent video show you what they are doing. It is the same cabal of the slave trade. It is the same thing they did to Abraham Lincoln when he wanted to stop the slave trade, when it became obvious that he wanted to stop the slave trade. And for those who may not know, part of the reason Lincoln wanted to make that move was because when he was younger, he saw a Negro woman being separated from her child and the woman was crying. And again, remember, they also told their own people that the Negroes do not care about their children or their wives. They had no affinities for their siblings. They had no loved ones. So if they had a child, for example, a woman could have a child and just give that child to you. Bear that in mind. So when you hear the likes of Wike, who are just house Negroes, telling you that if you kill their children, it doesn't matter, don't think those things do not make sense. They will write them down for the next generation. So the children growing up in the next years to come will very easily be told that the Negroes do not care about their children, they don't care about their wife, simply because a house slave called Wike, saying what his Fulani masters asked him to say, said that he doesn't care if his children were killed or his parents were killed and all that. You need to bear that in mind. That's how all those stories started. Now, we challenge you to go and look at the Nigerian story. It will help you understand that the alleged killing of twins is a lie. Even before we make our own presentation, we might not get to the end of it in this video, but our interest is to lay the groundwork so you understand the terrain we are looking at. And so, on this map, you will see that on the northern part of it, you see where it's written Royal Niger Company. That shows you who owns it. It was just a company. They believe that those are their farms or slave farms or plantations. So that's why if you shout for something like self-determination, they get their slave hunting partners to start killing you. They don't care, because even if you run to any other European country, they are all together in it. They agreed to respect each other's colony. So that's what you're saying. So don't be deceived by all these things they are saying, one Nigeria. Ask yourself, if they are telling you one Nigeria, who does it benefit? It benefits the slave master. And going forward, on the bottom right hand side of the map, you will see Cameroon. You also see Adamawa. Remember, we mentioned to you that before the 1961 plebiscite, these parts were part of Nigeria. But this is 1898. You can see that the color is different, because at that time, it would have still been a German colony. The Germans owned it, that's Cameroon. Before whatever happened, it was split between the British and the French. So you have French Cameroon and German Cameroon. Now we ask you, have you wondered why the slave master can come to your place, choose what he wants to do? If you make noise, somebody from your place will be asked to come and kill you, and the person will foolishly come and do it. But you can do the same in his own place. We give you a little example with the BBC. The BBC was the official propaganda channel of Nigeria during the Biafran War. Remember, the Nigeria was controlled by their slave hunting partners. Remember, it was the same BBC that told the world that starving children were due to famine. You need to bear that in mind. But today, the same BBC is all over the place, getting interviews from people. And the Biafra or Radio Biafra cannot broadcast from that land. And you still can't see that we are still slaves in that land. So if we asked you today, looking at it, Royal Niger Company, you see their oil companies in what you call Niger Delta today, and they are drilling the oil, doing whatever they like. You can't talk about it. If you think you can talk about it, go and ask Sarowewa, and you notice that it was the army. The army were the slave hunters. It doesn't matter which tribe or race they come from, they are conditioned to lack any form of humanity or common sense. That's how the army is. It doesn't matter who it is. If you doubt us, bring anybody who is in the Nigerian army here. We will ask him one or two questions and you will see that their heads are empty. They were the slave hunters. They lack humanity. They lack common sense. And there is no better way to say it. We are sorry. You might expect us to be a bit more polite, to be diplomatic, but there is no diplomacy in it. That's the truth. The facts speak for themselves. They are just used as slave hunters, but today they are used to sustain the legacy of the slave trade in a different form, which is subject of a different video anyway. And so on the map also, you see on your left, you will see something like Benin. You will see further down Dahomey. At that time, they hadn't called what you call Benin Republic today, Benin, because remember, these things are partitioned along the positions of the slave masters. So the ones that belong to the French, the ones that belong to the British, the ones that belong to the Spaniards, the ones that belong to the Dutch, they are well demarcated. They have their maps. They have their records. So they use the armies in those places the same way they use them as slave hunters to sustain that divide. You can't tell us as an adult that somehow you believe that a bunch of useless men in the Cameroonian army are protecting Cameroonians from another bunch of useless people in the Nigerian army who are also protecting Nigerians from the Cameroonians. If that makes sense to you in any way, shape or form, please put it in the comment section. We want to hear from you. If you cannot put it in YouTube, put it in library. At least there, it will not be censored as much as YouTube. And we'll see how that makes sense to you, that somebody came from Europe. Perhaps Lugard was not up to 50 years at that time, and draws a line and tells you that, you see, these are your brothers here. Any day they cross this line, they become your enemy. Kill them. And then he goes to Cameroon, does the same thing, and you are living like that. And you want to tell us you are a human being. If you believe that, then certainly you can't qualify as a human being. You see somebody like Nweke today. We shall look at that in a subsequent video, but our interest is to see how he is telling you that you have to stay in your state. You can't come from your state to his state. Meanwhile, he is speaking for the Fulani that are not even from Nigeria. He is telling you that you can't come from your state, but he is still talking about one Nigeria to tell you how unfortunate it is that such a person is a lawyer and a governor, supposedly protecting you or anyone in a state. But he's telling you that you can't come from your state to his state, but he wants you to be in one Nigeria and put a flag talking about freedom. That's exactly how the slave trade happened. At that time, if Negroes rose up, some of them will go and snitch. Some of them will go and tell massa that these ones are planning to riot, these ones are planning to demonstrate. The same thing, if you doubt us, conduct your research. And going further, you can at least see French Sudan, you can see French sphere of influence on top, you can see French Congo to the bottom right of Adamawa and Cameroon and all that. Our interest is for you to understand what is happening before you take sides. When you see all those shouting for one Nigeria, those are predominantly the Fulanese that hide as enemies within, and then those who do not know what is going on. So imagine where somebody is taking money that belongs to you and him, doing whatever he likes with it. And your own duty is when he gives you a little of that money, you start singing praises for him, even when the money belongs to both of you. We shall look at that in a subsequent video. Our interest is for you to see how the Europeans partitioned Africa to their own benefit while using their slave hunting partners to sustain that divide. Sometimes you see some people who come to this channel to tell us that we are dividing Africans. Now ask those people where they are when there are wars, why they do not talk about it. If you notice, the same way the slave master does not talk about Biafra and Ambazonia, is the same way the media there, the governments there, do not talk about it, because they work together. The slave hunters and the slave master are still working very closely together. Let us also reference letters and sketches from Northern Nigeria by Martin S. Kisk. And this was published 1910. And here we see another map. And in this map, which was circa 1910, you'll see they now have Northern and Southern Nigeria. Please bear in mind that North and South are not words indigenous to Africa. So there is no way those words could have existed. But they have created that divide or that demarcation or that designation or whatever you choose to call it. It was now this thing they called amalgamation in 1914, which didn't happen. They just start saying it. Whatever they want to do, they just start saying it. That's why you see somebody like Nweke, supposedly a lawyer. At least go and listen to his interview with Mamodu. Ask yourself how a lawyer, supposedly educated, can be talking the way he was talking. The moment they go to that Sokoto in return for power, whatever they do to them there, whether they hypnotize them or whatever, you will see that they lose that ability to reason as sensible human beings. And you notice that in that interview, he said they are rivers. Rivers is an English word. Remember, this thing is Fulani and British conquest, the slave hunters of old. There's no difference. That's what they are still doing. So they are saying they are now rivers, which is an English word. So no language in that sub-region has a word for who they can be, except an English word. That's why you see that the slave master rules the area through the Fulani, because they give them whatever they want done and they do it. They partition you the way they want and give you a name. You can't get a name for yourself. If he doubts what we're saying, let him say he wants to change the name of the state. Bring his elders to say they want to change it to anything he likes and see if the slave master will let him. He knows anyway. That's our interest, for you to know that those people are just mere lackeys and stooges. They are house Negroes. They are not doing anything. They can't do anything different from what Massa has asked them to do. So ideally, you see here that they say Northern Nigeria up and Southern Nigeria down. You might be thinking that Southern Nigeria will start, let's say, at the confluence of River Benue and River Niger, but that's a lie. Northern Nigeria is almost very close to where you have it written. That's how they planned it. Remember, this is as at 1910. So you understand how they've been doing it up to this moment. It is the same thing they are doing. So when you hear Wike saying they are rivers, he is just regurgitating what Master said you must say if you want to remain in power. That's how they do it. It's a very little trick, but you will understand it when you understand the history and remember that we have been lied to all over the place, from religion to education to history. It's all lies from the slave masters and their slave hunting partners. And if you looked on the bottom right hand corner of the map, you will notice that he wrote Cameroons and in bracket German, because at that time it still belonged to the Germans until they fought over it. Remember, they just used Africa as a battleground. Forget whatever you are thinking, there is no independence there. Their slave hunting partners are still in charge. And because of their lack of humanity and common sense, like the Nigerian army, we show you their atrocities all over the place. That's what they are. And that was the same thing they were during the slave trade. But at least you see here that this Cameroon, which is where you have Ambazonia today, struggling for the same freedom. So when you see them talking about Biafra and Ambazonia, you understand that they are victims of the same group, the same slave hunters, the same Fulanis in both Cameroon and in Nigeria are behind the slave master's ability to enslave the people there. And if you looked on the left, you will see Dahomey, which is a French colony. Our interest is for you to see where they are coming from. Things like Benin were created by the slave masters. Those things were not there originally. We want to ask you again, when you say you are from Southern Nigeria, there is no word in the Nigerian diction in their original languages that is South or North. Those things were brought by the slave masters. So you need to bear that in mind. So when you hear some people say they are Niger Delta, ask yourself, how come they are answering a name that is in English? What were they? Niger Delta is just the delta of the River Niger. That river was not called Niger. It was the slave master that called it Niger. Remember, the ultimate goal of the slave master is to exterminate the Negro race. That's what they are working towards. It doesn't matter if you believe that or not. You will see it yourself when you research it. Even if you don't believe it, it doesn't mean it won't happen, because that's what they are working towards. And so, in a nutshell, you see how the slave master came after the slave trade, because he needed to repackage it. Obviously, Lincoln's Emancipation Proclamation of 1863 and the activities and pressure from the abolitionists took them unawares. So they repackaged their slave trade in the form of colonialism and came down with it. We shall look at that in a different video, but our interest is for you to see how Nigeria can easily be broken down, their conquest, how they are doing it. You see that they came and said it was Nigeria, and then they broke it into two, North and South. Then that North and South, they broke it down into Eastern region, Western region, and Midwestern region. Remember, that's where they need the divide. From the Eastern region, they now have Cross River State, East Central State, and River State. All these states were created by the slave hunting army, because they operate through that army. They understand that the army is in their hands. They control it. Ask yourself how you can have a brother whose only job is to kill you in defense of the interest of a foreigner. The same way, if you notice the governor of River State, he gives us a little example of how the slave trade happened. You notice that he wasn't the one that went physically to shoot the people, it was the army, but they planned it. So when the army will be coming, they tell him what to say. He's a house Negro, he has no right of his own. Forget all the brigandry and all the gragara. He doesn't have that clout. He is just there for the slave masters, the Fulanis, and of course the British. So now, they went to do whatever they did. His duty is to defend whatever they did. He can't do otherwise. That's who they are. So now when they write their records, it's going to be that he did. So in future, somebody will say, you did it yourself. It wasn't us. But remember, it was Diame that physically went there to shoot people. So you understand how it was done. The same way they did their slave raids and slave hunts. When he's telling you they killed security agents, those are not security agents. How come the army does not protect people from Fulani herdsmen, but he claims to be the army of the nation? Think about it. Have you seen where the army protected anyone from Fulani herdsmen? And